This segment is for the carnivores in the crowd. I am cooking a steak. I'm searing a steak in a cast iron skillet, grandma's skillet, and it's simple, it's basic, it's perfect. And when you do it the right way with the simplest of ingredients, you're speaking to the French and you're talking about the steak and pommes frites crowd. And so let's get started. I've put my burner on, cranking up the heat a bit, and I'm putting my cast iron skillet. You don't have to have a cast iron skillet. You don't want to do this in a nonstick pan because a nonstick pan isn't great for super high heat. So you want something that you can really sear in. So either a cast iron skillet, and Lodge actually now makes these pre-seasoned cast iron skillets. So mine is so well seasoned that from wonderful years of pan searing, but they come pre-seasoned and really pick up a patina, which is what it's called, after a very short period of time. So let's look at the great steak, right? This is a ribeye, well marbled. Gotta tell you, this is from Kansas City. It's where my husband's from. So what you want is to take the steak, first thing, take the steak out of the refrigerator 20 minutes before you're gonna sear it or even grill it. We'll do a steak in another segment on the grill. But you don't want it cold going into the pan. So notice that while I'm prepping this, I'm letting my skillet heat up. So the simplest of preparations, I'm taking sea salt or kosher salt, sprinkling the steak on one side generously, great freshly ground pepper, a really nice, good crust of it, and that's all I'm doing. I'm gonna take unsalted butter, and I'm gonna add this to the pan. Okay, look at that. It's sizzling. I've got my pan hot. Okay, I'm going to take, now I also remember, in a cast iron skillet, the handle's going to get hot, so throw on the glove. Okay, this is not what you serve your cardiologist when he comes to dinner. Take your tongs, never a meat fork, and get that steak right into the pan. Now, the plate that I used to have the raw meat on is not the plate that I'm gonna use to put the finished steak on. And you want your plates or your platter warm so that you're not putting this perfect steak onto a cold plate. So warm your plates. Now, the tendency is you're gonna wanna nudge and shove and poke and pinch, and you don't wanna do any of the above. What you want is to get this great caramelization on the steak. On one side, you only want to turn this once, and then you're going to want to turn it onto the second side. Now, this steak, I would estimate, is about 3/4 inch thick. So the determining factor is how thick the steak is. But I want this medium rare. I'm going to pull this steak, and you'll learn temperatures, and they're in the recipes in my book. I want to pull this steak at about 110. I want it really rare in the center. So I'm going to estimate that this has been on about 2 minutes. Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous. So remember, we seasoned the first side before it went into the skillet. And when you turn the steak, you want to season the second side. Get a little bit of salt, good grind of pepper, so that you get the great flavor on both sides. Oh, yum. Look at that. Great caramelization. Turn it once. Look at that great searing around the edges. And, you know, if I can see that the pan, now I'm going to adjust the heat just a little bit. I've got the butter sizzling. And one of the things you can do, I mean, I'm a purist when it comes to steak, so I'm not looking for a pan sauce. One thing you could do is, you know, this butter is now, when it's finished, is well caramelized. It's picked up a bit of meat juices. And what you can do is throw a little bit of freshly minced parsley into it and then spoon a little bit of the butter over the steak. But honest to goodness, or over some potatoes. If you roasted potatoes or mashed potatoes that we're going to do in another segment, be fabulous over it. So what I want to do is the same thing. I mean, this is so simple if you just have the right tools. The great pan, a pair of tongs, and your instant read thermometer. So what I want to do is estimating, I want to take the temp. So I'm going to stick the thermometer into the steak just to get a sense of where it is. And I'm at about 100 degrees. So we're going to let that sear another minute or so, and we'll pull it at 110. Now, the other secret to a great steak, we've got bringing it out of the refrigerator, 20 minutes ahead, using a pan that can take the heat, butter in the pan. The other is that you want to let the meat rest when it comes off the pan. You don't want to, I know the temptation is, let's dig in, but if you let this meat rest for 5 minutes, all the juices will stay in the meat, the steak will still be hot, and you won't lose all those juices, especially if you were going to slice it. If you were doing a big T-bone and or a larger sirloin and you wanted to cut it and you wanted to slice this down, you would, and this is actually a huge ribeye. This is like a 14-ounce ribeye. So honestly, I know that it's, some of you would eat the whole thing, but this would really be better served for two. And so you could slice this down, but if you let it rest for 5 minutes, you'll get, all the juices will stay within the meat. So let's just do another temp. Keep an eye on it. Oh yeah, we are perfect. Okay, turn the heat off. Just letting that one edge just pick up a little bit of caramelization for a second. Now, when you take the heat off, when you take the steak off the heat and put it on a plate, it's still cooking. So even if you pulled it at 110, which is pretty medium rare, it's still gonna go up a few degrees while it's resting. Okay, how is that? If that doesn't look like, oh yeah, I'm ready to slice meat perfection, I don't know what is. So, and if you want, you know, you can give it a sprinkling of a little bit of salt when it comes back off. Okay, that is steak 101. Simple as could be, one pan. If you need to cook steaks, get yourself a larger pan. Don't crowd the pan. Give it enough room around. But I'm pretty content with that. Didn't make any pommes frites, but we'll imagine.